knows a lot about the science stuff. Professor Dave Explains.
We hear the words natural and synthetic all the time when talking about food, medicine, clothes, and other things. But what do they mean? If you took a poll, most people would tell you that natural has to do with their juice cleanse, organic groceries, yoga, and other healthy activities. But for synthetic, they'll warn you of toxins, scary chemicals, and mean, confusing chemistry teachers. With all of these charged emotions, it's not surprising that a lot of people equate these words with good and bad. But this discounts everything chemistry has to offer society, so we need to change this view. Natural simply means made by nature, the same benevolent force that brings us deadly viruses and toxic blowfish, which look strangely similar. Synthetic means made by humans, who save lives with antibiotics and synthetic microbes that eat up the oil from a tanker spill. Now that we've decoupled these words from good and bad, let's look at something both nature and humans make. A vitamin is something we must consume in small amounts in order for our cells to keep normal function and metabolism. Most plants and animals make these on their own, but somewhere along biological evolution, a few mammals lost the ability, so we have to eat them. Take vitamin C. For thousands of years, we've gotten this from fruit. But with modern science, we can identify the structure of this and other compounds and make them ourselves. The question is, are they the same? To answer that, let's look at how a vitamin works. A vitamin has just the right shape to fit into an active site of an enzyme and make interactions that turn on the enzyme, like a lock and key. And just as it doesn't matter who makes your key, as long as it's the right shape for the lock, same goes for the vitamin. That's why any molecule that's these specific atoms arranged in this way is vitamin C. Nature makes this just fine, always has. But when nature does chemistry, it is limited to the normal pH and temperature inside a living organism. So it has to use big, bulky molecules to do blind chemistry. When we do chemistry, we can use any exotic compounds and conditions we want to build any molecule we want. And even though the pathways are different, the end product is the exact same molecule. So the bioactivity of a molecule cannot depend on how it came to be. An enzyme simply can't tell the difference. Furthermore, it is often cheaper and easier to synthesize these in mass quantities than to have to extract and purify from natural sources. So if we want to keep the growing global population healthy and well-fed, we have to get over the idea that science looks like this. Because science looks like this.